First clue, Sherlock.
It's almost noon.
Well, time means very little when you're unemployed.
Yeah, well, when you have friends, showering feeds everything.
I didn't know you were coming over.
I called, but you didn't answer.
Again, sleeping.
Well, it doesn't matter, just... Will you put some pants on, please?
Pants bad.
No, pants good. Because you're talking about butterfly jeans, then I'm on your side.
Very good. Bye now.
You're not seriously just going to sleep in bed all day, are you?
I am if there's a god.
I do this because I can. Come on, man. I've got good news.
I just want some sleep.
Look, why don't we just go look to the little coffee shop around the corner there, and I will tell you all about it.
Please. My landlord was up until 5 in the morning partying. I was up all day yesterday, hopping from bus to bus going to interviews. I just want some rest. Please, can I just get some sleep? And call you later?
No, pants. Come on. Trust me, I've got good news.
Don't care.
Believe me, you're going to want to hear this.
No, I won't.
It's about a job. Houston, we have liftoff.
Wait, no, a job? Like actual work? Like actual work I can do for money?
Like actual work. Work that you are qualified for, work that pays well, and most importantly, work that lets you spend time with your favorite person in the whole wide world.
You got me a job working with Steve Buscemi?
Moving on past the fact that Steve Buscemi is your favorite person.
Well, there's a lot that people don't know about.
Moving on! Anyway, I was talking about me.
You?
Yes, me. Don't say you. Like I just ran over your dog or something, okay? I have feelings, too.
You lost your job, too?
No, man. Look. I know things have been tough on you in the last couple of months, okay? You lost your job. You've been having to dip into your sister's college fund. Yada, yada, yada. Well, look. I've been talking with Milligan about you. He thinks he may have something.
You're kidding me.
No, he got in trouble with the FAA. He's been told that he has to hire somebody else for the floor. But get this, not just another air traffic controller. He has to hire a supervisor for the floor, right? Somebody who's in charge of the actual floor.
Well, what do I have to do?
Well, here's the tricky part. You have to pass a psych eval.
Why would that be tricky?
I mean, can you blame me? You've been forgetting a lot of stuff lately. And you asked me to take you on a welcome back pub crawl last week when I know for a fact that you haven't been anywhere.
Look, I've been stressed and I haven't been sleeping. That doesn't mean that I can't pass a simple psych eval.
Just do me a favor, okay? If there are any questions about little green aliens, check the box marked no.
I told you about that?
Oh, by the sixth drink, you were going to give the bartender your PIN number.
It was just a very, very vivid dream.
Oh, well, you were very insistent that you had just spent the last several months aboard an alien spacecraft.
Look, I was also very, very drunk.
All right, works for me. I mean, you would tell me, right, if there was something wrong?
Of course.
Because they do drug tests, so if you're on anything...
Have you ever known me to do drugs, Alex?
I have not known you to go on a pub crawl, but my two-day hangover says otherwise.
I'm fine, okay? So what do I have to do for this job?
Milligan wants to meet with you at 5. Here's the address.
Get some pants on. Foster, I was beginning to wonder if Alex had given you the message.
Milligan?
Yes?
Sorry, I am. I forgot where I was for a moment.
Please have a seat. So, did Alex tell you why I wanted to meet with you?
He did. I have to say I was a little surprised. He didn't exactly part on the best terms.
As I said, Foster, it was business. So here's the rundown. The FAA has been cracking down pretty severely. They want more direct monitoring in the tower. I've spent the last year convincing them that I can't be in two places at once. So they want a floor manager, supervisor, someone who can oversee and predict problems before they become disasters. And that's where you come in.
Yeah, I get all that. But why me?
I've been wanting more direct supervision in the tower for a while now. And since that incident with Dalton, we've been under close scrutiny. Losing you has caused a bit of a slowdown. Most people are now afraid to sneeze the wrong way. I'm hoping bringing you back will at least instill and relax the tower for a little bit.
Does it pay more?
No.
Is that part of why you're offering it to me? Because you figure you can get me cheap?
Am I wrong?
No.
So you're in.
So I'll have final say.
In the tower, yes.
So I'll outrank Dalton? Like, legitimately. Like on the totem pole, here's me, and here's Dalton?
You would technically be above Captain Underwood, yes.
Then I'm in. Can I start tomorrow?
Not quite yet. We have to have you pass a psychological exam. The earliest the doctor is available will be Friday. If everything goes well, you can start Monday.
Alright. Sounds like a deal.
Excellent. Well, I've got to run. I'll send you all the information that you need.
Hey, Laura? Hey, No, I'm fine. Look, I'm about to hop the number 11 bus. Can you meet me at my place in about an hour? Yeah, the key's under the mat. No, nothing's wrong, it's just... hold on, the bus is coming. Hey, hang on! I'm on my way, hey! Look, no, I've got good news, actually. Anything happens to me. You know how you've been worried about paying for college?
College is the least of my worries right now, Jonah.
Well, you can cross it off the list altogether. I didn't want to say anything until I found work again, but I've been putting aside money for my paychecks for quite a long time now, and I...
didn't have to do that, Jonah.
Well, it's not like Cruella and Hodor were going to set anything aside for you, and I just wanted to make sure... Caroline and George?
Oh. True. Well, how much is in there?
About 80 grand.
What?
I had to dip into it a little bit to pay my bills these last couple of months.
Where the hell did you get $80,000? What did you do around the bank?
I've just been putting aside money for my paychecks.
You don't even own a car!
Yeah, and now you know why. I make good money, I just saved most of it for you.
I can't take that. That is too much. Like, insanely too much.
Well, it's there for you, so you don't really have much of a choice.
I felt bad taking $300 from you for my birthday. I can't take $80,000.
Look, law school is expensive. I told you to let me worry about how to pay for it.
I haven't even gotten in yet.
Look, let me do this for you, okay? I owe you that much.
Buster! We have been so worried. I've been looking everywhere for you. First I went to your job, but then your friend told me you were at this cafe, but then I couldn't find you there. But then I saw you get on the bus, so of course I had to follow you. Your landlord, by the way, is not a very nice man. He made me pay him like $20 just to find out which apartment was yours.
Who is it?
Is that a girlfriend? Did you tell me you're seeing someone?
Wait, no, it's my sister.
That's Laura? How exciting. Can I go meet her?
She's in the bathroom.
Oh, right. Manners. Sorry.
I'm sorry. Do I know you?
What? Well, come on, Foster. It's me. Rainya. We've been worried about you, buddy.
I'm sorry, I have no idea who you are.
Of course you do. Rift? Broke? Jira? Brax? A little dog made out of spare parts? Newton? Giblets? Little tiny crystals?
But clearly you got the wrong guy, so I just need you to-
Who is it?
It's nobody!
Look, I've got to remember, I can't get you back unless-
Look, I don't know who you are, but you can't be Rainya Decker, because there is no Rainya Decker. There is no Rift. What you're talking about is crazy, and I'm not crazy, okay? I just got my life back together, and I can't do crazy right now.
No, you're not crazy. It really happened.
No, it didn't. It couldn't have, because I'm not missing. According to everybody else, I never went missing, okay? So it was all a dream. A very vivid, very real dream, but a dream. Okay, so either I'm still dreaming, or I just lost my damn mind. But either way, things are going really well for me right now. I've got my job back, I've got my sister. I don't need whatever this is, okay? Look, just in my head, so get out. This is my home, and I'm not going anywhere.
Foster, look, you don't have a choice. You're not really here, this isn't your home.
Yeah, well, it sure isn't yours, so why don't you do yourself a favor and get out.
You don't mean that. I'm gonna go check in with the others. I'll be back. We'll figure this out, buddy. I'm sorry, what am I doing here?
Just get out!
I'm sorry, but could you just tell me where I am?
No!
Foster, is everything okay? I heard you yelling.
Laura?
What do you mean, Laura? Who are you expecting? Are you okay?
You're pregnant.
Nothing is past you anymore.
Why didn't you tell me you were pregnant?
What are you talking about?
You didn't tell me you were pregnant.
You've known for months.
No, I haven't.
Yes, you have.
No, I haven't.
Yes, you have. No. I'm pretty sure you did, because you're the one who arranged the adoption with Mr. Underwood.
What?
Trying to say, oh, 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 to play. It was a night on the middle of the day. Little girl, do you hear that sound? What you gonna do when there's no one else around?
Thank you for saving Rainya. I know you didn't really have much choice in the matter, but thank you all the same.
You're welcome.
And I'm sorry for what I,
knocked the living daylights out of me? Forget it. No, I hope in the future not antagonizing the man who's going to be keeping you all safe might be a fair expectation.
Fair. You know, I swear I know you.
Sorry, Foster. You don't know me at all. This is Danichu to the ORUS. I repeat, Danichu calling the ORUS, come in. This is Danichu calling the ORUS, come in, please. Somebody's blocking my signal.
Danichu?
Crawlins, is that you? I didn't think my signal was getting through.
It's not, at least not to the ORUS.
Then where are you?
In a shuttle, latched onto the Rift's hull. I got pulled into the interstitial field and the Rift jumped. Been trying to get into the cargo hold ever since.
Hold on. I need to block the internal sensor so they can't track our movements. I'm opening cargo bay too. Can you get to it?
One sec.
I'll meet you there.
I'm on the way.
Monitor her vitals and let me know if anything changes. Bro? What's wrong? Do you hear the silence?
The silence?
Dr. Decker does not like silence. It reminds her that she's alone. Will she be alright?
Yes, Brock, she'll be alright. We're gonna let her rest for a little while.
She has been unconscious for 21 hours.
Being unconscious is not rest. To rest, you must be able to dream. It regenerates the mind and body.
I understand. Do you dream?
Everybody dreams. It's one of my favorite places to be.
Why is that?
Well, a dream, it's a possibility.
Dreams give us hope. They elevate us. They're windows to what we desire, and they let us experience things we could never hope for. My grandfather used to say, we're all made of dreams. So without them, we are nothing.
You said everybody dreams, but I do not.
It's different. You're special.
Thank you. You are special too.
No, if only that were true.
You are strong, compassionate, kind, beautiful,
but I'm not important, bro. But one day I wish to be. One day I wish for people to look at me and know that because of me they're gonna have justice. That they'll be safe. My grandfather to be proud of me. Ra is nothing if no one ever hears it.
Is it important that they do?
Of course.
Why?
It's about honor. It's about honoring people you love.
But are they not honored by the act, action, rather than the knowledge of the act itself?
No, that's not the same thing, bro. When you honor someone...
Maybe it is you who does not understand the concept as well as you thought.
No, maybe I don't. But I want my grandfather to be proud of me. I need him to know that I'm a good person.
done things and my life broke. I need to know that the good outweighs the bad.
Are you sure it is not yourself you are trying to convince?
You are special. There's no getting around that.
Yes, but I still wish to dream.
Discover what you want in life. You'll find your dream.
Is that something your grandfather would say?
Something that I say.
What are you doing? You said I am to discover what I want. I am to dream.
That's a misunderstanding. These feelings are not yours.
But these are the feelings that I have, if they are
not
mine.
No, it's a malfunction. You should not have these impulses. Everything you're thinking and everything you're feeling is wrong. When Rainya is well enough, I will speak with her about repairing the damage. Good night.
But if these are not my feelings, then who am I?
Any luck?
Not yet. But we really need a seatbelt to be right up around me. Well, you and I is all we got. It's a shame the computer core is so badly damaged I could have done a work bypass.
No time to worry about that now. All right. Let's work this through. We need to contact the ORUS, jump back to the ship, and do it all without alerting the crew.
Well, we need Seiko. I'm going to say that right now. I could keep trailing, but I'd just be wasting our time.
So we need Seiko if we have any hope of contacting Seiko.
That's about the ship. Terrific.
What about moving the ship?
I could jump us back to the last known coordinates, but the ORUS was in pretty bad shape. We jumped back in front of Brax without having a chance to wave the white flag, and she might get us from another contract suite. That's it, they're still leaving the same place. We jump and don't find them, and we lose our element of surprise. Say, you got any more of those recon discs? Try to hit the rest of the crew with them. Shouldn't be too hard as long as I stay away and stay.
Dr. Hacker! I thought you were still resting.
I was. I couldn't let him get past his headache.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Hi. I don't think we've met. I'm Dr. Rainya Decker.
This is my associate, Jacob Crawlins. He's the other doctor on the ORUS.
I'm sorry. Were you in the bridge earlier? Everything's kind of hazy.
He was, but you didn't get a proper introduction. You look fine. Your neural activity is a bit high, but that'll come down on its own. I can give you something for the pain if you'd like.
That'd be great. Thank you. Foster? Foster? Hey, what happened?
He's all right. He had some trouble sleeping, and he asked for a sedative. He's asleep, that's all.
In the middle of the floor?
I think he thought it was slow acting. He must have. I expected him to take the sedative back to his quarters, but he administered right away and passed right out. I broke his fall. I just didn't know where his quarters were, and I wasn't sure what to do with him. Do you want us to take him back to his quarters?
No. That's all right. I don't suppose much can happen to him here. Thank you, again, for everything that you've done for us. Gio never really told me why you decided to help us.
We discussed it with your security officer. When you find your homes, we take the ship back to our commander.
I don't believe it. All it took to get everyone talking is me being in a coma. You know the same thing happened when I was 9? My mom and dad were having this huge argument over weeks with them barely talking to each other, and then I nearly blew myself up one day while trying to construct a lithium battery in the garage, and just like that, everything was fine again. They were on speaking terms immediately, and I heard back within a couple of months.
Well, the thing to do now is to worry about getting your crew home. So, you're the ship's engineer?
As best as I can tell, yeah.
We were having trouble with the comms unit. We were trying to contact Brax to let her know that the ceasefire was intact, but it seems that your signal doesn't get past the hull of the ship.
Well, we had a blocking signal up, but I didn't realize it was still active.
Can you take a look?
Sure thing. Well, that's weird.
What?
There's a neural imprint that's been squeezed into the system memory.
Could it be from when our engineer started the memory dump in your computer?
Maybe, but a neural imprint should never look like this. Broke? Broke. Alright, where'd you go, sweetie? But the internal sensors are all offline. Without internal sensors, the internal comms aren't functioning. Did you guys disable these?
It wasn't us. It must have been Foster.
Well, why would he do that?
I'm sure he had a good reason. I would leave him alone until we got more.
Well, without internal comms, I can't even contact Broke. It doesn't make any sense.
Do you want me to wake him? It's easily reversed.
No. Let him rest. He must have been really worried about me, huh?
You have no idea.
Holy Heinrich, hurts!
What? What's wrong?
It looks like feedback from the contra and repulsion wave blew several of the control crystals. It looks like somebody just dynamited a disco ball back here. Try canceling the signal block again.
Still no luck.
Oh, the vibrational resonances of the crystals is damaged. That must be why Foster disabled the sensors.
Can you fix it?
I can fix anything if given the right parts. I'm gonna need another ACT.
Why's that?
Well, when the primary resonator blew because of the booster signal Braxton Foster installed, I was actually able to replace the primary with an HCT. Now, because everything was channeled through that single crystal, I installed a backup in case the primary blew again.
And it blew?
No, but the backup did. Basically, we're flying on a wing and a prayer right now. Everything on the ship is leaning on a single fuse, and if it blows, we are all dead in the water. Best to have a backup. A backup, a backup.
Good idea.
Well, there's no time like the present.
Oh. Well, is there anything we can do to help?
Fetch me an HCT, would ya? They're in cargo bay 13.
Hey, I was hoping to, I've got it. You just watch out for him. Sure. Yeah, I got this. You go find Marcus.
Find who?
His brother.
Oh. Was he here from the ORUS too?
Not exactly. Cargo bay 13?
That's right. I'm off. Yeah! What was you doing this to me? Seriously? What is wrong with him?
There's something wrong with Foster.
There's nothing wrong with him.
He's unconscious.
He's asleep.
Asleep?
Sedated.
Why is Foster laying sedated in the middle of the bridge?
He did it to himself. Can't say I blame him. I had trouble sleeping when I first arrived. Sedated myself a couple of times.
You're supposed to be resting.
There's too much to do. This thing blew pretty bad when we were trying to run from the ORUS. Gotta get her humming at 100% if we're gonna get home.
We unlocked the flight history of the ship.
What?
See for yourself.
Oh, that's fantastic! There are a few blank spaces here and there, but we should definitely be able to reconstruct the journey home with this. Well, that's weird.
What is?
These coordinates? They appear to be part of a relative geospatial positioning algorithm, except for these last few sequences here. There doesn't appear to be any purpose for them.
Right, there's extra data. I said that.
Let's go see if Brooke is feeling chatty. She might be able to clear some of this up for us.
We might want to wait.
What?
Her behavior is a bit erratic. It's causing, undesirable effects.
Like what?
There may be a little bit more of you in her than I'm entirely comfortable with.
Too much of a good thing, or is one of me bad enough? I was joking. I didn't mean to.
No, it's okay. It's not.
Something wrong? Something you want to talk about, just between you, me, and the wall?
No, I don't think it's appropriate.
Well, I don't think Sleeping Beauty here would mind.
The life of a member of the Nautla is a solitary one. It does not lend itself to attachment. While you were unconscious, Foster berated me for not taking the time to get to know you better, for keeping you both at a distance. So I thought I should let you know that, despite my better judgment, I've come to know the both of you very well, and I consider you my friend.
Aww. That's so sweet.
I consider you my friend, and that's how I want our relationship to stay. That being said, if you would like to become better friends, I would be a member.
I like that.
Excellent. Do you want me to go for a throw?
Oh, yeah. If she's going to be up looping around, we got to make sure she's in good shape. You know, I can run a comparative scan against my own neural imprint and see if the overlay overtook too much of her system. If it did, I can identify the individual neural imprints and delete them.
Right, but that won't affect her memory?
No, I should be able to separate out that data. It might take me some time, but I can do it.
Good idea. I'll be back. It's good to have you back.
Dr. Decker? Dr. Decker?
I found him!
Quiet!
Do you want the whole world to know this?
Sorry.
John Dick. Marcus?
Yeah.
He's in apartment J194. Vital sector stable.
And the rest of the bank.
Only up 0.7% loss at this point. That's almost 8% under prediction.
Yeah, but they can't hold out indefinitely. Our predictions are off in our favor at the moment.
That can't last forever.
Well, I could start the reconstitution procedure. And we could have a dozen to provide for leaving what's going on.
Too risky. If something went wrong with reconstitution, we'd be exposed immediately.
What then?
I'm going back to the bridge.
What? Why?
Dr. Decker's repairing his communications. Until that's repaired, we can't do any good. Besides, the longer I stay out here, the greater the chance of being caught by that security officer.
What do I do?
Stay hidden. Monitor the comms unit and come and get me when it's up and running. And they won't make our move to retake the ship. As long as they don't know you're here, we still have a chance.
I could puncture the fuel containment cell to get involved. The coolant's harmless, but it should mask my biosignature and send us back online.
Good idea.
What's all your friend here? I don't think they'll arouse suspicions eventually.
At this point, it'd be suspicious if he disappeared.
Yes. Don't do that! What kind of person just pops up like that?
Sorry.
No, you're lucky I wasn't Jira. She'd have...
What?
Nothing. I think I just realized I owe Jira an apology. What are you up to?
Oh, I was just,
It's not the attenuators. I checked those components already.
I thought they might be misaligned.
No, the attenuators only reduce the amplitude.
But wouldn't the maximum migration oscillation have an effect on the signal's ability to travel?
It would, but it's like checking the engine when there's no oil in the car. Can't really test much if you can't get it running. I mean, you should know a lot about these systems for a doctor.
My friend Sita was teaching me a bit. She's the comms officer and bridge engineer on the ORUS.
Well, not to worry. I'll get this all fixed and we'll all be home in a jiffy.
The sooner the better. Say, do the attenuators affect the signal strength?
No. The way the signal is formed, it has no reverberation. The destination has to create a reverberant field, otherwise the signal just disappears.
What if we wanted to make a reverberant envelope?
Well, then you need something to act as an artificial reverb. The signal decay would be proportionate to the size of the envelope created, but even then I doubt we'd be able to transmit any coherent information.
That's perfect.
Why?
Just a theory. Thanks.
I know.
You know.
I know. That it was you who gave me the antidote to the stuff the rats gave me. You decided to come back to me. I know you went against orders, and I just wanted to say thank you. All right, old girl. Let's get you working.
For over 24 hours and I cannot wake him.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Look, I know he's not your favorite person, but I would appreciate if you come take a look at him.
Of course. By the way, how are the repairs coming? What happened?
We don't know. Rainya said it's a sedative. Maybe the dose was too large.
I am unable to read his vital signs. My skin is getting disinfected. I feel so isolated. I cannot tell his breathing. I cannot detect his heart beating. I cannot tell anything about him, and it's like he's not really even here.
It's all right. It's all right. Just let me take a look at him. Stable. He's just unconscious, that's all. You're probably right. He probably over-administered a sedative. He may be out for several days, but I wouldn't worry too much. He'll probably wake up feeling like $1 million.
Thank you. We were beginning to worry.
Did you want me to check her out, too?
No, I don't think that would do any good. I think hers is more of an engineering problem, not a medical one.
Why can't I hear them? I should be able to hear them. That's like what I was alone for. Night. After night comes and I feel cold, it needs to be night. Night will make everything better. Connected. I need connection.
Are you sure about that?
Broke? What's wrong?
I sense nothing. It's just the dark, cold blackness of space. You are not really here. I can't see you. I can't feel you. You need to sweep me off my feet. You need to be my knight in shining armor.
Rainya was supposed to look at her personality in Grimm's yesterday. Broke with some recharging. Maybe I'll go
back. Oh, don't bother. Try re-engaging the internal sensors.
Are they offline?
I think so.
I can't. I'm on a protected lockout.
Yeah.
Health. Nominal, all signs, accounted for, and stable.
What did you do?
It must have went down when the console blew. I just re-engaged him.
Okay, thank you.
Seems to have worked quite a bit.
Morning, all. What's going on here?
I was worried Foster had not regained consciousness, so I asked the doctor to take a look at him.
Still unconscious? How much sedative did you give him?
You gave him. Stay here.
Any change?
Vital signs are stable, but physical processes have been slowed.
Like a form of hibernation?
Correct.
I wonder. Could that be Foster's imprint I found squeezed in the system memory?
Insufficient data.
I'm so sorry, Foster. I should have known so much sooner that something was wrong. Any sign of Jira and the doctor?
No, I lost their biosignatures when they entered Cargo Bay 2.
But the cargo bay didn't open?
No, I believe they are still on the ship, but I do not know where.
Ugh! Come on, Jira, it's been hours!
Yes.
What?
You asked if there was any way they could be masking their biosignatures.
No, I didn't.
There is a variety of natural and artificial methods for dampening biosignatures.
Is there any way to tell what method they are using?
Not without sufficient data.
Can we determine a way to counter it?
Not unless we know how they are masking their biosignatures.
What are you doing? Stop it! Are you alright, Broke? I need to take you offline. Just stop talking, please. What are you doing this? Stop it!
That's enough, Broke. Something is wrong with your operating system, and I'm going to fix it. Whatever it is, I will take care of it. All right, Broke, you just need to trust me. Okay, Broke? Would you like to conduct a full scan of my personality now, Dr. Decker?
Yes, I think so. Let's get you hooked up over here, Brooke.
All right, hold it right there.
Dr. Danichu, come to peddle more bullpucky, have we?
I'm sorry for the deception, but it's for the greater good, believe me.
There isn't a whole lot I know for sure of in this life, but if it's one thing I do know, anytime someone uses the phrase for the greater good, it probably isn't.
I'm sorry you feel that way.
Have you prepared the comms unit?
Just about. I had to grow new harmonic resonator crystals, and they won't be ready for another 2 days.
Where's your friend?
Don't know.
Oh, come on. You can do better than that.
Honestly, I don't know. She was following you when her signal just disappeared like yours did.
Brooke, where is the security officer?
Unknown. Bio signs. Lost.
All right. Damn it. Unhook her off of that.
No, I need to...
No, you don't. You need to unhook her off of that. We're going to take a page out of your security officer's handbook. You two are going to go down to the brig. You two are going to be my prisoners until I get this sorted out with the ORUS.
It's nice to know you respect my tactics.
How long have you been back there?
A couple of hours. Sit. Once the computer core was destroyed, I figured this was the only strategic position available. Now, let's talk about waking up Foster, shall we? Much, but he said Foster was fine and that we shouldn't worry.
You didn't hurt him too badly, did you?
I didn't hurt him at all.
Oh. I just
assumed I would torture him.
Yeah, I mean the bruises.
That was Foster.
Foster?
Yes. He is very protective of you.
I'll say.
Did you get anything useful out of Rogue?
Not really. All I could get out of her was the word recon? Recon, what could that mean?
She could have meant retcon. It's a process my people use to change memories. It's a very good tactic for inserting operatives into enemy territory.
So what, we just sit by and let him rewire Foster's brain?
At the moment, yes. He said Foster is fine, and I believe him. We need to get more out of Brooke. We have no bargaining power with Danichu, and he knows it.
What about those genome banks? We could threaten to shut down the support system for those.
Well, it could work, but if Danichu calls our bluff, we'll have no more leverage left to play.
I have an idea, but it'll take too much time.
Did you at least figure out what was wrong with Brooke?
Somewhat. It appears the personality imprint has caused a little bit of an identity crisis. Now, instead of overriding the existing software like a program should have, it's hybridized with it, stringing together all the different personalities and the memories, too.
Oh.
Yeah, as best as I can tell, there's the original operating system, my print, and then there's this third print that doesn't appear to have any purpose. Mm. Again, at least as best as I can tell. She's a very advanced computer. There's a lot that my scanners aren't telling me, and I don't know why.
We had talked about using the previous crew files. Brooke has since unlocked them. Is that still an option?
It should be. I should be able to wipe my personality and keep the memory files intact. It'll take me some time, though. I'll have to sort out the data that is and isn't related to the personality profile, and then I'll have to check the crew files and see what data is appropriate. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll get on it.
So now we wait.
It's about time. It's been 5 days, and I've been...
No more games. Talk.
I told you, your friend is fine.
Not about him.
About this.
You?
this ship.
No, I won't. There's no power on this ship that can make me.
We shall see. You have them?
Right here.
Do you know what these are?
Those are the genome storage cells. They're very delicate.
Right. 6 million people, you said.
That's right.
We did the math. Each case holds about 1,000.
No!
Answers now!
Do you have any idea what you've just done? These are lies you're sharing! Real actual people!
That's 2,000. Should I go for 3?
No, look, I don't know if you know how serious this is. It's like, ow! Stop!
That's 4,000! 4,000 lives in your hands. 1,000, you refuse to honor our bargain. 1,000, you choose to believe that your desire for comfort is greater than our desire for safety. 1,000, something is wrong with our friend and you won't tell us what. And 1,000, our names are in those crew files and you won't tell us why. 1,000 lives for each failure. Is the cost in lives worth it to you? Or should I raise the price?
It's not a spaceship. I mean, it is, but it isn't. It's not just a spaceship. RIFT. R-I-F-T. Revolutionary Interdimensional Frontier Transport. I wasn't lying. It's a lifeboat, a colony ship, but it's not meant to colonize another planet. It's meant to colonize our own. Another Earth. We were looking for another habitable Earth. One that has all the resources we need already in place and can sustain an overnight population increase of 6 million people. It's not an invasion. We were looking for another habitable Earth. That's where Foster is. I gave him a recon disc. It's a neurobiogenic transmitter. It allows the host consciousness to inhabit the body of its double on a parallel world. They're used for scouting missions. I just locked out the return function, so he hasn't been able to return home.
But then why are we on the crew files?
Because your doubles in my reality were the original crew. On my world, Dr. Decker, you designed this spaceship.
Now what?
That's it. It's signaled neurologically. All he has to do is think about returning and tap the back of his hand 3 times.
What, you can't just pull him out?
No. I activate it without preparing him mentally. If you pull him against his will, it sends him into a neuroleptic shock.
Do you have more of those discs?
I do.
Can you send me down there to find him?
I can, assuming that your double isn't his reality.
Yes,
do.
Wait, that's not gonna work. What if your species has something in contact with his in this dimension?
Your species?
Jira's from another planet?
There were no aliens on the Rift crew.
So, are you saying she's human? Moving gracefully on for the time being. A planet is a huge place. I mean, how does she expect to find him? Couldn't her double be in a different country for all she knows?
Actually, he shouldn't be too far away. The Rift is drawn to dimensions where the crew exist at proximity to each other for decent scouting and analysis.
Let's do it.
Foster, tell him to come home, buddy. Tap his hand 3 times. How hard could that be?
Just be careful.
Who are you talking to? to. I built a fusion reactor when I was 17. A little foster hunt, I can handle.
You don't have to keep staring at me. Where am I gonna go?
You had your chance at thrust and you chose to waste it.
Don't I get a second chance?
Second chances must be earned.
What's going on with her?
She must have completed the scan.
Possibly.
Rainya has been scanned for all personality subroutines. When she found the files, she scanned the computer to erase them.
What?
It was damaged, just the only way to repair the damage.
You gotta stop,
stay back.
No, you gotta let me stop the program, please.
Give me one moment.
Just look at the diagnostic readout.
And I have retaken the rift. I'm going to empty the prisoners to the brig right now.
Well done, Crawler. I'll put together a boarding team, lower your shield, and we'll empty over momentarily.
Understood.
We had a deal.
What's that energy you filled up?
I don't know.
It's not the engines, is it?
No. It's the EMT.
How can that be? The shields are still up.
I don't know. I'm lowering them now.
Construction
complete. Purging. The EMT isn't coming from the
ORUS. Where's it coming from?
It's coming from the rift.
We gotta get out of here. They're still coming.
Captain Tannis?